What's up, guys? Wannabe fraternity boy hanging out at District Marbell. We've got Brian here hitting chest, I believe. And then Peter just went in there watching some basketball right here. This is my second video in a row at District, but I honestly don't come here that much. I'm usually in Boston at the Gold's Gym. We're going to hit shoulders. It's going to be good. I keep talking. Let's just start it. Okay, here's our deal. This is what I look like now. We're doing a high volume shoulder day. Ideally, we do a little bit of inflating in the next like 45 minutes. I'm gonna try to keep this one quick. For those of you who like quick workouts, this is for you. Not gonna be super heavy, gonna be high volume. I just said that, about to take PE science, high volume. Keep saying high volume, but yeah, let's do it. Guys, so how I usually like to do my shoulder days, and I think the most effective way to do a shoulder day is to start with an overhead press movement. Usually that's you're gonna be your strongest lift for the workout. You just saw there, yes, I was using lighter weights for myself. I was using the 60s, but went for five sets. I think it was five sets, yeah, five sets of 20 there, and I was not supersetting with anything. Usually my high volume workouts, I do like a superset between two exercises. So from here going forward, that's what we're gonna do. So, like I said, heaviest movement of the shoulder workout, make it your first, make it an overhead press movement, hitting primarily your front delt. That's knocked out. Now what we're gonna be doing is supersetting a rear delt movement and another front delt movement actually. So we'll do those two. And then after these two exercises, we'll hit the medial delts. Guys, four sets, not five. Now, moving on to some lateral raises, hitting the medial delt. Also, not sure exactly what you want to call these. Usually people do rows on these for back, but I'm gonna flip it up and use it for a single arm, kind of shoulder press in a way with the barbell. So that will also hit the front delt, a little bit of the medial delt. Got about 50 pounds on there, plus the bar might add another like 15 or 20 pounds. We'll go for roughly 15 reps there, and then when it comes to the lateral raises, maybe like 15 to 20, and we're gonna drop set too using the 25s, and we'll drop down to the 15s. Let's do this. End of the work week, just like that. Now, it is time for some legs, because what better way to start the weekend, right? Got all this snow. I'm not gonna be doing anything outside. Might as well be doing stuff in the gym, right? I'm gonna be there anyways, regardless, even if it was sunny and nice out. We're gonna be doing lunges with barbell. We're going to be squatting with barbell, obviously. Other movements as well. So, without further ado, I'll see what goals. Focus on. We're focused. Del, what are we doing today?
Some squat. Maybe some sled work. If he's man enough. I'll see what else.
So funny. I'm really tired, guys. Like 3 hours of sleep last night. editing a video for you guys, the one with Chase. I was up super late last night, but that's no excuse. We're gonna hit this leg day hard. Low bar squats to begin with, I think, because heavy weights and all that stuff. So, just warming up right now. Bell's at 225 right now. I don't know why, but I'm feeling strong, so I might go for a PR. Not sure. We're gonna see how 405 feels. And if 405 feels good, then I'm gonna use that as my gauge. 315 next. I said I was gonna go for a PR in that session. Didn't happen. And then after you saw, I think 405 was the last set you just saw. I just got a spray tan because I'm super pale. I totally left the gym after that 405 squat. Been feeling so tired today. Like, told you I didn't sleep that much. And it just felt like shakiness in my like core, like in my body. And I was just like, you wanna know what? It's not worth it. Cold tonight, so that's what we did, and not worrying about it whatsoever. We'll hit it hard tomorrow, working out with Josh tomorrow, Josh Bryan. We'll talk more with him tomorrow, but yeah, we're gonna go get food now and then go home. Is that what normal people do at night? They go to bars and stuff? What is that? Yes. And then, yeah, we'll do one of these. And then, cause balance, chicken. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. It was kind of just a high volume shoulder day, and then I transition right into a leg day, albeit brief leg day, the next day. This was Thursday and Friday. So I cut my leg workout short, and honestly, it was because, like I said, I was feeling shaky, kind of just feeling like, you know, just really tired from the week, and I listened to my body, and I was like, you want to know what? I can do 4 or 5 more movements. I should do 4 or 5 more movements in this leg day, but it's just not worth it, and I feel like you could potentially push me over the edge and like make me sick. And guys, that kind of comes down to when to take a rest day and when to know when to stop. And it's different for everybody. And if you're relatively new to the fitness game, new to lifting, you can take potentially a rest day every other day or every third day. Because I've been doing this for so long, I've been lifting for 8 to 9 years, 10 years now, I can go like 9 or 10 days without taking a rest day if I've been optimizing my sleep and my diet and everything is firing on all cylinders. But in this case, or like today, that wasn't the case. So I kind of listened to my body, took that rest. Guys, it's important. And if you're anything like me, I love hitting the gym. I love going there. I'm the type of person that when I get sick, or when I'm feeling run down, I still want to make it to the gym. I don't want to like make an excuse. I still want to stay active. So it was kind of difficult for me to just step back and just say, I don't want to do this. I wanted to do sled pushes with Dell, and I was looking forward to that. But either way, the takeaway from this, guys, is listen to your body and understand that rest days are just as important as your days in the gym. Rest days is where your body grows. Your body grows while you're sleeping. Your body grows while it's not in the gym. And if you just continue to hit the gym constantly and avoid rest days because you think it's gonna help you progress faster, that's not the case. You can end up tearing down muscle fibers and they don't have the time to recuperate and grow into bigger muscle. You can get sick. You can, you know, push your immune system down and just like be weaker all around. Take your rest, take your necessary rest. That's all I'm gonna say. Hope you guys have a great Monday. And I'll see you in the next video with Josh Bryan hitting chest. And maybe some other stuff, who knows?
I hold you close in my mind. I see you again. I see it in my dreams. So just stay strong, you won't